And now it comes to the next part of our program, and I'd like to invite Dr. Jeongjun Kim to come forward to give the fieldwork report. This is the shorter report, and I will give her the introduction. She will then go on to do a small workshop to inspire others to do likewise. You may come up, Jeongjun. The ladies may take a seat. Now, as an introduction, after the last World Convention, we had a situation whereby, how would you say, sometimes you have an idea and you pray to the Lord, and it became and evolved so that I could see the advantage. You remember back in the old days that the missionaries went out and they carried the message, and I thought, how can we contact the message, get the message out to the missionaries? And it came to me that Dr. Jeongjun Kim would be the ideal person to contact the Korean missionaries in different countries. And I had no idea how it was going to work, but it was a trial project. And if it did work, if she did manage to get some contacts, and I can hear a lot of people coming behind me, but then we could give it over to other countries as well, that they contacted their missionaries and increased the work in that pot. So having said that as a basis for this missionary work, and I see missionaries as a Christian, and they are ideal people who understand the damaging effects of alcohol, tobacco, and all other addictive substances, different in each country, upon the people there. And very often they are poor souls who need the word of God and think if they can also get the word of temperance, which is God's work. In my mind, the temperance cause is also a mission. So I'll give the word over to Dr. Jeongjun Kim. Thank you very much.
The last fruit of the Holy Spirit, self-control, in Greek is enkrateia, which is translated in some versions of the English version as the temperance. Very correct translation. Okay, the next. You already know well the important purpose of the WCQ, as you see on the screen. Okay, and the next. Francis Wheeler, our founder, sent field workers around the world. Field workers formed new national temperance unions or helped missionaries to promote temperance works in their mission fields. Mary Greenleaf Clement Leavitt was the first field worker, and she herself was the first missionary around the world. I am cooperating with many Korean missionaries. Korea is a small country, but it is actively sending more than 27,205 missionaries to more than 171 countries by 2016, last year. Now I'm going to introduce you briefly new unions and works promoted by Korean missionaries during the last 3 years. First, Cambodia. I met a Korean missionary, Mrs. Lisa Han, who is working in Cambodia. She organized Cambodian WCTU in 2012. Mrs. Lisa B.L.D., Korean ambassador's wife to Cambodia at that time, helped the CWCTU to be a registered NGO in Cambodia. After that, CWCTU has been able to give monthly temperance lectures at schools, universities, and factories, as you see in can you see the joyful smiles of the employees? Korean missioners in Nepal, Ms. Michelle Ko, is also working with us. She organized WCTU in Nepal and has been giving temperance education to students of the schools she founded and to villagers in Himalayan mountains. Alcohol abuse, addiction to nicotine, and other drugs are pervasive in Nepal. Now, let me talk about Vanuatu. When I first suggested the temperance work to a Korean missionary, Nam-Joo Kim, she was not sure about its necessity besides her missionary works. Nevertheless, when she realized the widespread kava addiction in Vanuatu, she could not but agree to start the temperance work for her mission field. And now, Senegal. Mrs. Yang Jin Kim went out as a Korean missionary to Senegal in 2015. She had worked before for 7 years as the director of Child Care Center of Korean WCTU. She is now preparing the temperance education at schools and the churches which she is in charge of. Next. Retired Korean missionary, Mrs. Hyun-Soo Kim, newly dedicated herself to the temperance work. After 15 years of medical and educational ministry with her husband in Western Samoa, she still has a good network among public officers. She keeps sharing WCT materials with them to influence on public officers and regulations on alcohol and FAS issues. I'm making more contact with Korean missionaries in England, India, Philippines, Tanzania, Vietnam, and even in China to carry out temperance education in their mission fields. Most recently, just before I come out to the World Convention, I heard that in Kyrgyzstan, Mrs. Jeong-suk Lee, who is present on the podium, supported a Korean missionary to establish a big kindergarten. From this September 2016, he is going to start the temperance education among the children. Now, are you ready to hear the voice of each field from the missionaries present on the podium, starting from Cambodia, Nepal, Vanuatu, Senegal, Western Samoa, and Brazil.
Clean Tea campaign in public, our members wearing WCTU uniforms and banners. Clear the streets and distribute temperance flyers. Many people in high position in public sectors as joined our campaign. Amazingly, our campaign was broadcasted by 7 televisions and newspapers. Every month, 20 to 30 young Christian students are getting for service. We are training them as future leaders. We face and temperance split. Please pray for Cambodia WCTU.
I am Mia Lee, the advisor of Cambodia Union. It's my great honor to introduce myself and the activities of our union at this precious moment. My husband was the Korean ambassador to Cambodia. 4 years ago, when my husband and I visited Korea for the ambassador conference, I met Young Joo Kim, the Vice President of WWCTU. After coming back to Cambodia, I met Korean missionary Lee Jahan, who just set up Cambodia WCTU with the help of Dr. Jung Joo Kim. We met WCTU at different places, but we came to cooperate in Cambodia together.